हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेशन टू ऑफ यूनिट वन इलेक्ट्रिकल सेफ्टी. इन द लास्ट सेशन वी लर्न वेरियस इलेक्ट्रिकल सिंबल्स, देयर मीनिंग्स, सेफ्टी साइंस, वार्निंग साइंस, पीपीई एंड टाइप्स ऑफ पीपीई. इन टूडेज सेशन लेट अस कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन इलेक्ट्रिक शॉक और इलेक्ट्रोक्यूशन, डेमॉन्स्ट्रेट हाउ टू फ्री ए पर्सन फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रोक्यूशन, फर्स्ट एड टू विक्टिम अंडर इलेक्ट्रिक शॉक, इलेक्ट्रिकल फायर्स, causes and precautionary measures, use of appropriate fire extinguishers on different fires, rescue techniques applied during fire hazard, inform relevant authority about any abnormal situation, earthing and types. At the end of the session, let us have a quick revision with multiple choice based questions. Let us start with the topic today. What is electric shock or electrocution? An electric shock or electrocution is a condition when electric current runs through the human body and it can always be dangerous. An electric current passing through the body can cause tissue damage, burns, or it may leave no visible marks on the skin. Fibrillation. What is fibrillation? Fibrillation means it causes irregular contractions of the heart muscle fiber, which may lead to blood clots, irregular heartbeat, strokes, or even cardiac arrest or other injury. Under certain circumstances, even a small amount of electricity can be fatal. That is, electric shock can even cause death. A small voltage of around 30 to 50 volt range is enough to drive current in the human body. And a current of around 1 milliampere, 1 milliampere is 1/1000 of a ampere. Such a small current can cause tissue damage or fibrillation. If the current magnitude is high, around 50 ampere, it may cause cardiac arrest or even more severe effects. So we should be very careful while working. Here picture is showing that the person getting electrocuted when he comes in contact with a live wire or the case, the metal cabinet or the metal cover of some appliance, when it has developed the potential due to loose wire or insulation fault. See, now the person or the operator, he is in contact with the case which has developed the potential due to some fault. And you can see that the current is flowing through his body to the earth. Thereby, the person is under shock now. Human body is a conductor of electricity and the body resistance depends on so many factors. The contact area, moisture, skin type and many other factors. This shows the consequence of electric shock. You can see a kid playing here with the socket and the extension cord with the plug. There are chances of getting shock, and this picture is showing us the consequence of shock, which has caused electric burns and bleeding also. Let us now learn how to free a person from electrocution. Iga yargo shock agide. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನೀವು ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಹೌ ಟು ಫ್ರೀ ಹಿಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಶಾಕ್. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕೀಪ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಟಚ್ ದ ಇಂಜೂರ್ಡ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ವಿತ್ ಬೇರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್. ಬರೀ ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ವಿತೌಟ್ ವೇರಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಗ್ಲೌಸ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟಚ್ ದ ಇಂಜೂರ್ಡ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ವಿತ್ ಬೇರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್. ಯಾಕೆ ನಾವು ಮುಟ್ಟಬಾರ್ದು ಬರೀ ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂದರೆ, ಈವನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟಚ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಆರ್ ದ ವಿಕ್ಟಿಮ್ ವಿತ್ ಬೇರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಚಾನ್ಸಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಮೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗೆಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಕ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್. ನಮಗೂ ಶಾಕ್ ಆಗೋ ಚಾನ್ಸಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಇಫ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಸೋರ್ಸ್, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಸೋರ್ಸ್, ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಮೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗೆಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಕ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ನೆವರ್ ಟಚ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಜೂರ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಬೇರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಇಸ್ ಟರ್ನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಇಫ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್. ಇಫ್ ದ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಿಯರ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಲೊಕೇಟ್ ದ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಟರ್ನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ. If not possible to turn off the source of electricity, or sometimes the source may be far away, then don't please waste time going to the location. Try to isolate the person first. How to isolate a person? You can use a non-conducting object such as wooden pole, object made up of cardboard, paper, rubber, plastic, or wood. Andre, in general, you can use any insulating material to remove the person from electrical source. First thing you have to do is you have to isolate the person using the non-conducting object, using any insulating object. Like one bundle of paper tagolbodu illa andre broomstick handle, it is made up of plastic, and keep in mind it should be dry, it should not have any moisture. See, this picture is clearly showing the person rescuing the victim by using a wooden stick or a wooden pole. See, this victim is still in contact with the source of electric current, so he is trying to isolate him in this picture. And once you have removed the victim from the electrical source, check to see if the person is breathing. First thing you have to do is you have to check whether he is breathing and if he is having a pulse. If necessary, administer CPR. CPR andre cardiopulmonary resuscitation until emergency personnel arrive at the scene. So you can call other emergency helplines that is needed. Medical services, you can call 102, 108, 112. For fire station, you can call 101. For electricity supply companies, for intimating the electricity supply companies, you can call on the helpline numbers. For BESCOM, it is 1912. This is how you can free a person from electrocution. And what is the first aid to victim under electric shock? What you should do? Isolate the person from the source. Then get him out from the contact of the electric source. Then keep the victim lying down. Unconscious victims should be placed on their side to allow drainage of fluids. Do not move the victim if there is a suspicion of neck or spine injury unless absolutely necessary. If the person or the victim has a neck or spine injury, please don't move him because it may lead to still serious injuries like paralysis or other things. So do not move him unless until it is very crucial or very much necessary. Then if the victim has no pulse or if he is not breathing, you can start with CPR, cardiopulmonary resuscitation, along with mouth to mouth resuscitation. Then cover the victim with a blanket to maintain body heat. Keep the victim head low and get medical attention. So this is the first aid what you can do. Now let us discuss in detail CPR, cardiopulmonary resuscitation. Resuscitation andre revive, bringing back to consciousness anta. What is CPR? CPR is an emergency procedure that combines chest compressions often with artificial ventilation. Illi neevu picture alli nodta irbodu nodi chest compressions kodta idare, along with that they are providing artificial ventilation also. Andre iga CPR yaru kodbeku? It has to be given to person who is not breathing, who is unconscious, unresponsive, or abnormal breathing, or who is under cardiac arrest. These conditions galalli naavu CPR na administer maadbeku. Yakandre in the case of cardiac arrest, the heart will stop pumping and the blood will stop circulating. So under this condition, to preserve intact brain function until further measures are taken to restore spontaneous blood circulation and breathing, we have to administer CPR. Blood circulation no bega restore maadbeku matte breathing bega restore maadbeku andre now CPR immediately administer maadbekagutte. Blood circulation adashtu bega naavu brain ge blood circulation na restore maadbeku, or else it may lead to serious injuries. Yeah, let us discuss about artificial ventilation or respiration. Mouth to mouth resuscitation is a form of artificial ventilation. This is a part of CPR, where it is the act of assisting or stimulating respiration in which rescuer, she is the rescuer, rescuer presses their mouth against that of a victim and blows air into the person's lungs. Here the rescuer is pressing her mouth against the victim and trying to breathe into the victim's lungs. This is very much crucial for reviving breathing again. Resuscitated a victim under cardiac arrest. As already told, during cardiac arrest, the heart will stop pumping or beating, and so the blood circulation is stopped. That is, the whole of the circulatory system is affected under cardiac arrest. So in that condition, you must act immediately. ಆದಷ್ಟು ಬೇಗ ನೀವು ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಚೆಕ್ ಕ್ವಿಕ್ಲಿ ವೆದರ್ ದ ವಿಕ್ಟಿಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಅರೆಸ್ಟ್. ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಅರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅಸರ್ಟೆಂಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಆಬ್ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಪಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್, ಬ್ಲೂ ಕಲರ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ದ ಲಿಪ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೈಡ್ಲಿ ಡೈಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಪ್ಯೂಪಿಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಐಸ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವೆದರ್ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಚೆಕ್ ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಅರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೇ ದ ವಿಕ್ಟಿಮ್ ಆನ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆನ್ ಎ ಫರ್ಮ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಶೋನ್ ಬಿಲೋ. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಲೇ ಹಿಮ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, loosen his clothes, and then you have to see. Now this is the procedure. Place the palm of one hand on the center of the lower part of the breast bone, keeping your fingers on the ribs. Now cover this palm with the other hand and lock your finger together as shown. Now keep your arms straight. See, now the arms are straight. And press sharply down on the lower part of the breastbone. Then release the pressure. Repeat the above steps 15 times at the rate of 1 per second till the victim responds. See, idu now illi varge madbeku, until the victim responds, and it should be at the rate of 15 times per at the rate of 1 per second. Ee tara madkondo we have to try to bring back the victim into consciousness. Continue this exercise till the arrival of the doctor. This is how to resuscitate by mouth to mouth method. The first thing what we have to do is we have to place a roll of clothing under his shoulders to ensure that his head is thrown back well. You have to place and see that the chin points straight upwards. The chin is pointing upwards as shown in the figure. Then grasp the victim's jaws such that the lower jaw are higher than the upper jaw, and we have to maintain this jaw position so that the tongue will not block the air passage. This position has to be maintained, and we should be careful we should observe that the tongue is not blocking the airway. And once the victim is in this position, now the rescuer can press his mouth against the victim's mouth so that there is an airtight seal between the victim's mouth and the rescuer's mouth. Now you even have to pinch the nose of the victim with the help of a thumb and the forefinger. Now take a deep breath and blow into the lungs of the victim and see that his chest raises up. This is what you have to do. And after you blow the air into the victim's lungs and you observe that his chest is rising, then you have to remove your finger, release his nose, remove your fingers, release his nose, remove your mouth, and let him exhale. That is, he has to give the air out. He has to exhale the air out. The first 8 to 10 breathing should be as rapid as the victim response. Thereafter, the rate should be slowed down to about 12 times a minute. The first 8 to 10 fast aagi maadibidbeku so that the victim will respond, and after that you have to continue this at the rate of 12 times a minute. So this is about mouth to mouth resuscitation. Then next, let us check out the first aid for bleeding victim. Determine the location of the bleeding. The first thing is locate where the victim is bleeding. elevate the injured area above the heart if possible. Then what you have to do? Apply pressure, apply direct pressure, or you have to press against the part which is bleeding with sterile cloth. Keep the pressure on for 5 seconds. Keep pressing for some while and you check whether he or she is still bleeding. If not, apply pressure for some more time, like 10 to 15 minutes. Then clean the wound, bandage the wound with pad of soft material as shown. See, a pad is used here. A pad of soft material is used to bandage the wound. Then advise the victim to take treatment from the doctor. So this is how you treat a bleeding victim. Let us now see what are electrical fires, causes and precautionary measures that has to be taken to avoid electrical fires. Now let us see some of the causes of electrical fires. A failure or malfunction within the electrical components of equipment or machinery can cause electrical fire. There may be some malfunction which may cause fire. Fire start in the electrical panels from overloaded circuits or edge of the panel. If there is an overload, obviously there will be heating which may lead to electrical fire. Electrical fire may also originate in electrical wires, cables, circuit breakers. See, you can see some pictures of electrical fire here. A fire in the panel may be due to overload, and here in the cord. Now let us see the causes of electrical fire. The first cause is faulty electrical outlets. Most of the electrical fires is due to this faulty electrical outlets or worn out sockets which are not properly grounded. Most of the fires is due to these worn out sockets only. And the other main cause is outdated home wiring or worn out electrical wiring. If the home is 20 to 25 years old, then the wiring capacity of that home cannot handle the increased power loads, which is due to increased usage of electrical equipments like computers, microwave ovens, air conditioners, and these dishwashers also now because of the pandemic. Day by day we are increasing the load, but the wiring is the same. So there are chances of the outdated home wiring getting heated up and catching fire. So care should be taken there. Next cause is light fixtures. Sometimes we may use a high wattage lamps. High wattage lamps are fixed to light fixtures which are too high for the fixture. The fixture may get heated up, and sometimes we place cloth, paper over the lampshades, which may also lead to fire. So we should avoid those things using high wattage lamps to a low rating of the fixture. Next, portable heaters. And this is due to extended use of the portable heater, especially when we are not at home or when we are sleeping. We leave the heaters on, they will get heated up and chances of catching fire. And the other causes are cords and electric circuit overloads. One of the main causes, majority of the causes is fire is overloads. The wire tends to get heated up and catch fire. Frequently overloaded circuit breakers, flickering lights or intermittent power outages, appliances or electrical devices that feel excessively hot, shocks or sparks from appliances or outlets, unexplained burning smells. So these are some of the causes of electrical fire. Now let us check the precautionary measures. Repair or replace loose outlets as soon as you notice them. You have to replace the worn out sockets as soon as you notice them. Tighten the wire nuts to improve the connection, or you may need to replace the outlet. Get an expert to conduct a thorough electrical safety audit of your wiring, external power panels and electrical wall outlets. Install good quality smoke detector alarms and fire extinguishers to reduce chances of electrical fire and saving lives and minimizing damage. Yeah, you can go for detectors, good smoke detectors and extinguishers, so that you can save lives and also you can minimize the damage of the property. Choose heavy duty extension cords for every application. Never permanently rely on extension cords. This is what we do. We will buy something if there is no enough socket or no enough this thing. What we definitely go for extension cords, and we will continue using the extension cords. So we should not do that. We should plan for a socket where it is required of proper rating, and we should not permanently rely on the extension cords. Pay attention to your appliances. Check cords for excessive heat. If a device makes strange noise or operates improperly, don't wait until the cord catches on fire. Repair or replace it immediately. Now, if it is we may sometimes notice that our mixers or the machines, washing machine or the washer, dishwashers, what we use, they make strange noise, and we may get burning smell also sometimes. So in that condition, please don't wait till it catches fire. Take the appropriate action. Act immediately. Then use radiation heaters that do not catch fire on direct contact. Be careful not to overload light fixtures and replace ones that seem to get excessively hot when lit. So don't load the fixture. And if you are noticing that the light fixture is getting heated up, you have to replace it immediately. Now let us see the fire extinguishers on different types of fires. What is a fire extinguisher? A fire extinguisher is an active fire protection device used to extinguish or control small fires, often in emergency situation. We might have seen fire extinguisher everywhere, in schools, in colleges, banks, everywhere they place the right fire extinguisher so that they can act immediately and control or extinguish small fires. Fires are classified based on different types: class A fire, class B, class C, class D, class K. What are class A type of fires? These are the fires due to ordinary combustible materials like paper, rubber, plastic, cloth. If these things catch fire, then that comes under class A. In class B, fires involve fire due to combustible liquids. Combustible liquids like petroleum, diesel, gasoline, solvents, oil-based paints, oils, greasers, grease, tars, and alcohol. And also combustible gases like butane, propane, and methane. In class C fires, these are the fires due to energized electrical component like computers, motors, transformers, servers. Like that, if the energized electrical component catches fire, it comes under class C. And now if you remove the source of fire, it comes under other classes of fire. In some of the classifications, the electrical fires are classified under class E also. Class D fires, it is due to fire due to combustible metals. Combustible metals like aluminium, magnesium, this zirconium, sodium, potassium. If those metals catch fire, it comes under class D. And class K, it is mainly fires due to cooking oils, animal fats, and vegetable fats. So these are the general classification of fires. And any fire, for it to exist, it needs three things mainly, which is heat, fuel, and oxygen. And this forms a fire triangle. If you remove at least one of the element, then you are able to extinguish or put off the fire. So the first thing we have to do is to remove at least one of the element from the fire triangle. The different fire extinguishers will remove one of these elements to stop it. When deciding ways of firefighting, you need to decide on the type of fire extinguisher and where they should be located. This will guarantee that they are suitable for the type of fire that could occur and of sufficient capacity for the fire risk at the premises. Appropriate fire extinguisher. For fighting electrical fire, they go for carbon dioxide or dry chemical fire extinguisher. Why carbon dioxide extinguisher, or how the carbon dioxide fire extinguisher will act? This extinguisher will take away oxygen element from the fire triangle. See, now in the fire triangle, it will take away the oxygen element of the fire triangle, and also to remove the heat with a very cold discharge. You keep in mind, carbon dioxide fire extinguisher has a ice cold discharge, tumba cold discharge irutte. So that adra horn the discharge horn become very cold, and you cannot use it further, ashtu cold irutte. And there are chances of getting ice burns or cold burns with the usage of carbon dioxide fire extinguisher. So you have to plan and choose the carbon dioxide fire extinguisher mostly with frost free horns. For a frost free horns tagondre, you can avoid these cold burns or ice burns. And how it acts is by removing the oxygen, and also it is cooling the fuel. By removing heat, it is cooling the fuel, thereby extinguishing the fire. It is one of the suitable extinguishers for class C or the electrical fires. The next type of extinguisher is a dry chemical type extinguisher. It can extinguish the fire primarily by interrupting the chemical reaction of the fire triangle. In the fire triangle, you have a chemical reaction. It interrupts this dry chemical extinguisher will interrupt the chemical reaction of the fire triangle. Today's most widely used type of fire extinguisher is the multi-purpose dry chemical fire extinguisher, and this is suitable for class A, class B and class C types of fires. So these are the two appropriate fire extinguishers for extinguishing or fighting electrical fires. Yeah, these are the different fire extinguishers, and you can easily make out with this label here. If you see a black label, it is carbon dioxide fire extinguisher. This is a foam one, wet chemical, water. This is a dry chemical powder extinguisher. And the first and the last one are suitable for fighting in case of electrical fires. As soon as you see fire, you cannot blindly use any type of fire extinguisher. Don't ever use water or foam fire extinguishers on electrical fires, because they may even cause the fire to build up. More severe fires can build up if you use foam or water extinguishers. So keep in mind to use carbon dioxide or dry chemical powder extinguisher in case of electrical fires. And in order to remember the simple operation of the extinguisher, you can just remember PASS. What is this PASS? PASS is pull the pin. You will be having a seal here. Let's break the seal and pull the pin. And aim at the base. Wow. Aim this discharge horn at the base of fire. You have to aim the properly place the discharge horn at the base of the fire. Then squeeze the lever. See, you have the lever here. Squeeze it. Next S stands for sweep side to side. So you remember PASS, and then you can operate any extinguisher easily. Now let us now see the rescue techniques applied during fire hazard. What we have to do when you see fire, what steps you have to do, and how to rescue the people. First thing you have to do is alert people surrounding by shouting fire, fire, fire when you observe the fire. First, if they may be sleeping or busy in their work, so first if there is alarm, try to use the alarm and just shout fire, 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 so that people are alerted. Next, inform immediately to the fire service or arrange to inform immediately. If possible, you can call them immediately or open emergency fire exit and ask them to go away quickly. And one more thing you have to keep in mind is not just blindly opening the fire exit and pushing the people, but you have to check whether there is no danger of fire on the other side. Check that, and then you have to safely shift the people. Next, if there is smoke in the air, stay low to the ground, especially your head, to reduce inhalation exposure. Stay low so that you will not inhale the smoke there, and keep one hand on the wall so that to prevent disorientation, and crawl to the nearest exit. First, try to come out of that building. Once away and clear from danger, put off power supply if possible. Call and report the authority who is concerned with it about the fire. Go to your refuge area and await further instruction from emergency personnel. Proper authorities are to be notified of fire. So these things you have to do when you see a fire hazard. Now let us concentrate on the method to move the injured people. Correct method to move injured people. Do not move an injured person unless they are in life-threatening situation. Moving an injured person can worsen the injury. If the person has a spinal injury, it can cause them to permanently paralyzed. Until unless required, please don't move the injured person. Do not move someone if you think he has a spinal injury. And how to shift or move a person without a spinal injury? You can drag the person to safety either by leg or arm or clothing, depending on the injury type. First, try to drag him, then use the human crutch. Crutch is a equipment you may have seen. When you get fractures, you will get a metal crutch which gives the support to the shoulder. Here you can provide a human crutch. See, this is human crutch. He is providing his shoulders so that this person can walk. A person without spinal injury can walk. Then carry child using the cradle method. You can shift a child like this. And you can also carry a larger person like a backpack. You can carry him like this, and you can move a person without a spinal injury. Correct method to move injured person. When you have two persons, when the rescuer side you have two persons, how to move a person? You can move them using a human crutch. See here, two people are supporting this lady so that she can walk. The human crutch. Employing alternative carriers. Improvise a stretcher to carry the injured person by using tree branches or other straight pole like objects, a large cloth or blanket. Use blankets, bed sheet, bedspread, or any other cloth that is available. You can only design a crutch, design a stretcher by using poles, whatever is there, bedspreads or blankets, and design a stretcher. Fashion a stretcher using four hands, or you can fashion a stretcher by using hands like this. Carry the person with a chair. See all the pictures of a human crutch by human stretcher. This is by using a chair. It is shown clearly. And once you shift on, once you are out of danger, immediately you have to inform the relevant authorities. It's always necessary to keep the relevant authority informed for further inspection and maintenance. If it is a fault concerned with a HV line, it's necessary to inform to KPTCL or supply companies like ESCOMs by using the emergency helpline numbers. Okay, you have to immediately inform the supply companies. Then call 102 or 108 for medical emergency ambulance services. And for fire station, you can call 101, and supply companies, as already told, for ESCOM, you can call 1912. If you are not aware of these numbers, in case of any type of emergency, you can always call 112 for any emergency which is a police emergency number, where they will respond very quickly. The authorities, we have shown the pictures of the medical emergency ambulance there, a fire brigade vehicle, and this is the BESCOM vehicle. See, it has a ladder there, BESCOM vehicle, and this is a police vehicle. Next, let us learn what are the safety measures to be practiced in lab. You students should practice this. Use approved tools, equipments, and protective devices. Now, we shouldn't rely on the devices which are not approved. We have to see whether the tool is approved, and we have to use those tools only. Do not work under poor light or when you are tired. Do not work in damp areas or in wet shoes or clothes or wet hands. Keep tools and equipments clean and in good working condition. Read all the instructions carefully before using the appliances. To prevent electrical hazards, do not immerse appliances in water or other liquids. ನೀವು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಸ್ವೆಟ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದೇ ಕೈಯಿಂದ ಮುಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೂ ಶಾಕ್ ಆಗೋ ಚಾನ್ಸಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಮತ್ತು ಇಂಟೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಶಾಕ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹೈ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಅವರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡ್ರೈ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಅವಾಯ್ಡ್ ಇಮರ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಅಪ್ಲಯನ್ಸಸ್. ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಒದ್ದೆ ಬಟ್ಟೆನಲ್ಲಿ ಒರೆಸೋದು, ನೀರು ಹಾಕಿ ಒರೆಸೋದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು. ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇಮರ್ಸ್ ದ ಅಪ್ಲಯನ್ಸಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟಯರ್ಡ್ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಅಪ್ಲಯನ್ಸಸ್. And while connecting or always we have to unplug an appliance while cleaning or doing anything or rewiring enadru madvaga plug na tegdu bidbeku. First you have to unplug the appliance and then you can do your cleaning. Ensure that you pull the plug and not the cord. Bari wire itkolbardu, plug itkondo neevu adanna unplug madbeku. Do not operate any appliance with a damaged cord or plug. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕೆಲವು ಸಲ ನೀವು ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು ಪ್ಲಗ್ ಹೋಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದು ಕ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದೋಸ್ ಪ್ಲಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜ್ಡ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ಇನ್ಸುಲೇಷನ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರುತ್ತೆ ವೈರಿಂದ, ವಿ ಕೀಪ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್. ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡೂ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿತೌಟ್. ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ನೆವರ್ ಯೂಸ್ ವೈರ್ಸ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಇನ್ಸುಲೇಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲಗ್ಸ್. ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆನ್ ಅಪ್ಲಯನ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಎ ಡ್ರೈ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್. ನೀವು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎಕ್ವಿಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಇಡುವಾಗ ಡ್ರೈ ಇರಬೇಕು ಸರ್ಫೇಸು, ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಲೆವೆಲ್ surface. Keep appliances away from heated surface and open flames. Andre alle nindkondo eno madakbeku, candle on madbeku, idanna madana, using of match box or this thing should be naked flames should be completely avoided. Check the electric power supply from the switch position. These are some of the safety measures you people have to practice in the lab. And let us study now about earthing or grounding. The very purpose, the main purpose of earthing or grounding is to discharge leakage current or fault current to the electric to the ground safely. So the very purpose of earthing is that only, discharging of the fault current or the excess current safely to ground. So how can it be done? Connecting the metal body of an appliance or machinery to earth through a low resistance GI wire is called earthing or grounding. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಸೇ ಕನೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಕೇಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಕೇಸ್. ನೀವು ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು ಮೋಟರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲಾನು, ಯಾವುದೇ ಎಕ್ವಿಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ರು ಅದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಮೆಟಲ್ ಕೇಸಿಂಗ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಕೇಸಿಂಗ್ನ ನಾವು ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಎ ಲೋ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ GI ವೈರ್. GI ಅಂದರೆ ಗ್ಯಾಲ್ವನೈಸ್ಡ್ ಐರನ್ ವೈರ್ ಮೂಲಕ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನು ಅರ್ತ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ದೇರ್ ಬೈ ದ ಕಾಂಪನೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಅಪ್ಲಯನ್ಸಿಸ್ ಅರ್ತ್, ದ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅಪ್ಲಯನ್ಸಿಸ್ ಅರ್ತ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಡಿವೈಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅರ್ತ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿ. ಮೆಟಲ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಅಪ್ಲಯನ್ಸಸ್ ಎಕ್ವಿಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೆಷಿನರಿ, ದ ಅರ್ತ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ದ 3-pin ಸಾಕೆಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಮೀಟರ್ are connected to earth through a thick GI wire. So these things are earth. In nodi na picture alu torisidivi, in a 3-pin socket, this pin, the upper pin is earth, this is the face and this is the neutral. So ee 3 pin socket alli na plug hakat takshna automatically the component or the appliance will get earth to through this pin in the 3 pin socket. And already we saw the earthing of the appliance. And this wire, what is used for earthing is the galvanized thick galvanized iron wire or copper wire. That galvanized iron wire use martivandre it has very low resistance. And the necessity of earthing. Earthing yak madbeku. Earthing is necessary for all the domestic, commercial, industrial installation to protect the operators from shock. Mainly for this reason, to protect the operator from shock, to protect the equipments and buildings from lightning. Not only it protects the operator but also the equipments, because equipments are very costly. They charge lakhs together. In transformers ella tagondre they are very expensive. So we have to protect the equipments also, and they can prevent or at least minimize the damage to the equipment as a result of flow of heavy currents. And also because of these things the reliability of the power system will improve. So the earthing is very necessary. And now you can see a condition here where whenever a person operator is touching the metal case of the equipment which is in contact with the live wire. See, due to some fault or insulation fault or some loose connection, here the live wire has come in contact with this equipment. Since it is it has come in contact with the equipment and the equipment, the case is earthed, the case is earthed, then the charges, the body voltage comes to zero. The case will not develop any potential since it is earthed, because the fault current passes to the earth. And when the operator comes in contact with this case also, the operator is safe. He will not get any shock because of the earthing here. Yakandre nodi adu potential develop agakke bidalla, the body potential will come to zero through the grounding wire. And grounding wire mulka adu current it will flow to the earth, thereby protecting the operator. So it is discharging the fault current to the earth. Ade if the earthing is not done, see in this case there is no earthing and the live wire it is in contact with the case of the equipment. And now if the operator touches this case which is at high potential, he will get a shock. The current will flow through the operator's body to the ground. So see, you can make out the importance of earthing. You can, it mainly protects the operator as well as the equipment by building potential on the case. So this earthing is very much needed to discharge the fault current or the excess current. And if due to some reason such as short circuiting, an excessive current flows through the line wires, it will pass to earth through the earth wire if there is local earthing, else the line wires may get overheated and it may cause fire. Let us see the types of earthing. There are mainly two types of earthing, plate earthing and pipe earthing. Pratiyobru manellunu earthing maadsirthivi matte manegalalli maadsuvaga naavu nodabodu energy meter inda ondu galvanized iron wire hogirutte. It is directly to the earthing. Plate earthing. Figure shows the line diagram of the plate earthing. Here we are using a copper plate or a galvanized iron plate of this dimension, 0.6 meter length, 0.6 meter breadth and 3.15 millimeter thickness. We are using this copper or the GI plate, and we are embedding it vertically 2 meters below the ground level. Ground level kinta 2 meters deep alli idanna vertically embed madbeku, vertically idbeku. And the earth wire is connected to the plate. Il torsilla earth wire illi now connect maadi adanna connection ge horagade tagoltivi. And a square pit of 1 meter into 1 meter into 2 meters is dug. to facilitate the embedding of the earth plate, this copper plate. And now the pit is filled with alternate layers of salt, sand and charcoal. Why we are using these three materials? Because salt will increase the conductivity of the soil, and charcoal, it is adsorbent, it can retain water for a longer time. To decrease the resistivity of the earth, and thereby it can increase the conductivity of the electric current. Idereddu reason goskara we are using salt, sand and charcoal. Yakandre earth resistance should be below 5 ohms. We should see that the earth resistance should be 5 ohms, below 5 ohms, that is 0 to 5 ohms. So in nodi idike ond we have given provision also for adding water, so that water is a good conductor of electricity. And if it is moist, if the soil around this plate is moist, then the resistivity of the earth will be around or below 5 ohms. For this purpose we will add salt, sand and charcoal, and we should always see that the area around this plate is moist. The next type of earthing is pipe earthing. Here we are using a galvanized iron pipe of 38 millimeter diameter 38 millimeter and 2 meter length is vertically embedded in a pit. The pit is 1 meter into 1 meter into 2 meter and it is filled with alternate layers of sand, salt and charcoal, again decrease the resistance of the soil and increase the conductivity. And as told before, provision for adding water is also given. Earth wire is connected to this galvanized iron pipe and taken out for connection. So this is how pipe earthing is done. This is for today's session. And now let us have a revision with the multiple choice questions. Think and answer. I'm pretty sure you people can do it. When fighting an electrical fire, which of the following should not be used? Water fire extinguisher, foam fire extinguisher, dry powder fire extinguisher, neither A nor B should be used. The electrical fire fight maadvaga yava extinguisher use maadbardu? Water, foam, dry powder, neither A nor B should be used. So the answer is D. You should never use water or foam fire extinguisher for electrical fire fighting. Idereddunu navu use maadbardu. Let us go for the second one. The acronym for putting out fire using a fire extinguisher is known as PASS. What does it mean? Now idu discuss maadvaga nodidivi. Pull, aim, squeeze, spread. Pull, accurate, squeeze, spread. Pin, aim, squeeze, sweep. Pull, aim, squeeze, sweep. So four options, which is correct? And the right one is D. Now to pull the pin, aim, squeeze and sweep. This is PASS. Let us see the third one now. Which of the following should you not do if a person is in contact with a source of electricity and suffering from electric shock? Enna maadbardu when a person is under shock? Call 1912. It's also a helpline number. If safe, turn off the power or source of electricity. Option C is touch him or her directly with your hand. Use a safe object to move the source of electricity. Yavudanna maadbardu? The answer is C. Touch him or her directly with your hand. We should never touch the victim with bare hands. The next question is, electrical injuries are commonly caused by? Options are unsafe equipment or installations, an unsafe environment, unsafe work practices, all the above. The answer is day. All the above. You should neither use unsafe equipment, or you should not work in an unsafe environment, or you should not practice any unsafe work. So option is D. The fifth question is, shock is a condition where, the options are, the respiratory system fails to deliver air to the lungs, the cardiovascular system fails to deliver blood to the heart, the circulatory system fails to deliver blood to all the parts of the body. The last option is all the above. Shock aadaga yen agutte? What condition is it? And the answer is C. The circulatory system fails to deliver blood to all the parts of the body because the heart will stop pumping. So the circulatory system fails. The sixth one is, there are three basic steps you can take in an emergency. The options are call, check, care. Check, call, care. Recognize, decide, call. Decide, execute, call. The option is B. You have to check, call, care. Let's see the next question. The proper procedure for CPR is, cardiopulmonary resuscitation is, compressions, airway, breathing, airway, compression, breathing, breathing, airway, compression, none of the above. Yenu proper procedure, CPR do. The answer is A, compressions, airway, breathing. Let's see the next question. Which is not a rescue equipment? Which is not a rescue equipment? Options are stretcher, first aid equipment, self-contained breathing apparatus, portable fire extinguisher. The answer is D. Portable fire extinguisher is a firefighting equipment. It is not a rescue equipment. Now let's see the next one. If you choose to fight a fire, what is the first action you should take? What you should do while fighting a fire? First, activate the building alarm to notify the occupant. Check the extinguisher gauge to ensure it is full. Call police or call ambulance. None of the above. In first maadbeku when you see fire. And the answer is A. You have to activate the building alarm to notify the other occupants. Bere avarge first neevu alarm kodbeku, activate, notify maadbeku. And the last one is, if your clothes catches fire, stop, drop, and the options are sit, roll, sing, sneeze. If your cloth catches fire, stop, drop, and the answer is B, roll. You have to stop, drop, and roll so that the fire is extinguished or put off. So this with this we have finished the revision of session 2. Yeah, I would like to thank LMS e-content team members, Srimati D. Aruna Madam, Chairperson, SJ, Government Polytechnic, Bengaluru, Shri Vijay Kumar Sir, Coordinator, GPT, Chintamani, Srimati Shilpa Madam, Member, SJ, Government Polytechnic, Bengaluru, Shri Wajid Ahmed Sir, Course Moderator, GPT, Immadihalli, Bengaluru, Shri Hemant Kumar ML, E-Content Developer, Government Polytechnic, KGF, Kolar, and myself, Sony, Lecturer in Electrical and Electronics, Government Polytechnic, Ramanagara. Thank you all. Thank you all students for the patient listening. Thank you.